getting to know each and every one of you, working with you. I think Jackie covered the update pretty well, but I'm always here if you need anything, and I look forward to working with you.
I'm looking forward to having you. We'll need your car so we can call you regularly.
I'll get you my number.
Well, thanks, Jackie. On the main Stanley Town Road, with just, with the center of the pavement coming together, there's a lot of issues with that. And so I guess the asphalt plant is shut down probably right now, but anyway, you put that on there to look at. And I drove the other day, and it's just a pile of issues. I think a lot going on in Pilo, maybe somewhere down here as far as priority stuff, but anyway.
I would say that section of that road from National Tunnel Road to the Cloud High Road, it's planned for paving this summer, so we got that on the schedule.
Glad to know that.
Yes.
And the Hunter Valley West, where they're gonna pave from 619 Stony Creek, I think, what, a mile or so they're gonna pave that, you know, and that's on there too.
That's where we're at right now, working, so.
I know they've done some work there as far as the, they're getting ready to, I don't know when it's on the.
It'll be on the schedule for springtime, we'll resurface treated that project probably, so. We're hopefully gonna try to take that all the way up there to the church is our plan.
Those people appreciate that too. Any other questions for our VDOT folks?
Are you sure the last time I mentioned to you on East Quarter Valley? Is Bluebell, Bluebird Drive?
One of the off roads.
That goes into a subdivision?
Right.
Y'all have any updates on what you've looked into on that, or?
Now, is that the one that you're going to add to the?
Yes.
Well, now that's kind of be up to the board if.
Well, that one has been brought up many times before and has never been. It's actually paved all the way in there, actually as good a road as you'll find anywhere, pavement. But for whatever reason, VDOT has never accepted that into their.
It's probably, you know, an unpaved road, it's not in the current system.
No, it's paved.
I mean, I guess what I'm saying, it's not currently in the VDOT system. It has to go under, come in under the, and our unpaved road maintenance to be able to build and basically get it up to state standards. And I don't know, you know, the funds have not been coming into that as we would like, is to put on new additions. That may be some of the situation Marshall will have to check and see. It's kind of hard to get those, we're allowed a certain percentage of our unpaved road monies to develop new roads, kind of like the one up there off of buildings that we built. And that's probably the last ones that we've been able to build, you know, in Scott County due to the funding issues. They have to have a 40-foot clear right-of-way. Not saying the road has to be 40 feet, but state requires 40 feet. We can do a little more checking and see.
Appreciate it, thank you.
You have comments or questions for Jack here, Mr. Belcher?
Thank y'all for the job you do.
Yeah, appreciate you coming. It helps us a lot, we don't want to mention, probably VDOT issues, one of the biggest things that, and the things, the problem with trash collection, it's the biggest thing we hear, so. Y'all problem number two, so then thank y'all for coming.
I will get that information to you.
Okay, and I'd say Frida, she's got our contact information, so just feel free to. And we'll check on it.
Thank you.
One more. Is there a list of the paved roads in Scott County and not paved, and is there such a list that we could look at, or? I had a question the other day on Ballfield Road over on top of Midway Road, I don't know the number, but anyway. It's paved part of the way, and you know, it's not paved where the houses are, you know, it stopped so far, it's not very far. But then there are houses that it's not paved, and question is asked why, you know, why do they only pave part of the way and then not the rest of the way? You know, and it is, of course, this time of year, you know, it's gonna be muddy, we've had a lot of rain, if you put gravel on, dirt will disappear. And there's a lot of tractor agricultural around there too, so. But they were just wondering, you know, why they stopped and didn't pave the rest of the way.
We've got, I guess unfortunately in the past, that used to, they would look at doing half-mile stretches sometimes.
That's probably about how
We've tried to change that in the last 5 years to where we try to get to, you know, an intersection or somewhere that extends it a little bit more. But unfortunately, that doesn't